Captain Cheesehead. Hello, boys and girls. It's Captain Cheesehead and my good friend, Mr. Southerton. Mr. Southerton is going to review this quiz with you on the modifiers, adjectives, and adverbs. It's a 30-problem quiz. Mr. Southerton?
Thanks, Captain Cheesehead. Hello, boys and girls. What's up? If you look at the upper right-hand corner, this is a 30-point quiz, as Captain Cheesehead said. If you get, say, two wrong, you would have plus 28 points over 30. Minus one for anything wrong, show the corrections. If you take a look at the very top in the rectangle, you can see information about the adjective. These are describing nouns in this case. Nouns are pronouns. All of these are nouns. And we ask what kind, which one, how many or much. Those are the types of questions that we will ask. Leroy and Jenna walked up to an old castle. Here's the noun castle. What kind of a castle is it? Old should be circled. Old. If it's not like that, show the correction. Put minus one. Number two. Maddie put the golden key in the lock. Which one? Which key? The golden one. Number three. Today is the fifth day of January. Which day is it? The fifth one. Fifth should be circled. Number four. The baby birds flew from the nest. Which ones? The baby birds. Baby should be circled. Number five. Joe's truck has a flat tire. What kind of a tire? A flat one. Flat should be circled. Number six. Am I holding a marker in my left hand? I'm asking the question, which one about hand and left would answer that? You should circle left. I will be a little flexible here. The word my could have confused this. My acts just like an adjective. It tells which one. My hand, your hand, her hand, which one? So it does answer that question. It's describing a noun. It's just it's in the form of a pronoun, so we call it a possessive pronoun. Still, it acts like an adjective. So I will take off no points if you wrote down my or circled it, or if you wrote it down instead or circled it instead, because that would have confused you. In either case, my and left, both of those act like adjectives. Number seven. Patricia played beautiful music on her guitar. What kind? What kind of music did she play? Beautiful. Number eight. Has anyone read Caitlin's latest story? Which one? Which story? Her first story? Her second story? Her latest one? So latest should be circled. Once again, I will be lenient here. I will allow it if you circled Caitlin apostrophe S. Technically, that is a possessive noun. Okay, it's proper. It takes a person's name, Caitlin. But with the apostrophe S, that makes it act like an adjective telling which one. Caitlin's story, Mark's story, which one? So there will be no points off if you also wrote down Caitlin, or if you wrote it or circled it, I should say, instead. Latest is the best answer, but we would also accept Caitlin's and latest if that's what you wrote down. Number nine, the sly fox outsmarted the chicken. What kind of a fox was it? Sly. Number 10, Miguel ordered a large Coke. What kind of a Coke? Large. Shifting to the other modifier, adverbs. They might tell how, when, where, maybe why, maybe even to what extent or how often something was done. They can describe adverbs, adjectives, and mainly they describe action verbs, and that's what we see here. So we were to circle the adverbs in this case. I carefully glued the last piece onto the model. How did you do that? Carefully describes glued. Now, a lot of us might just see glued as a main action verb and assume that carefully comes before it and it's a helper. No, it's not on our list of 23. Okay, this is an adverb. And that's why you need to know what you're describing and what questions are being asked. Number two. Francis played on the beach yesterday. When did he do this? Yesterday. It does not end in ly, but it still is an adverb because it answers to the question when, about the action played. And speaking of adverbs, they can also come in the form of prepositional phrases and clauses. On the beach, and we're not circling this. The only answer I'll accept here is yesterday. But on the beach is really an adverb phrase telling where. Where is also an adverb question. Where did Francis play? Where did he do that action? On the beach. So we're going to see prepositional phrases acting like adverbs in the future. That's a future lesson. Today, just yesterday is the correct answer. Number three, I will visit my friend. When? Tomorrow. Number four, George, will you come here? In this case, actually have a helping verb there. In this case, here is telling where you want George to show up or arrive. Number five, they swam lazily in the pool. Where did they swim? In the pool, yes. But if I ask how did they swim? Lazily. So I need to circle lazily. In the pool, again, is a prepositional phrase, acting like an adverb, telling where. But we are not circling those phrases. Our instructions were just to circle the single word adverbs. And since I have this question out here, we should have gotten that down. They swam how? Lazily. Continuing to the next page, Neil slowly placed a card on the card house. How did he do that? Slowly. Number seven, they cheerfully sing songs. How? How do they sing? Cheerfully. Number eight, Nathan stamped his feet. How? Angrily. Angrily. Angry is an adjective. If I change that Y to an I and add L-Y, it becomes an adverb describing the action. So I could say Nathan is angry. Angry is an adjective describing the noun Nathan. Nathan stamped his feet angrily. There you see how the word how is answered. Angrily, about stamped. Moving on, number nine. My father snored loudly on the couch. How did he snore? Loudly. 10. Sam accidentally slipped on the ice. How did he do this? Accidentally. Number 11. Yesterday they played a game. When did they do this? Yesterday would be the adverb. And these adverbs can show up in different places. I could have yesterday come at the end of this. Capital T, they played a game yesterday. If I start a sentence with an adverb, however, such as yesterday, I should have a comma come after it. Yesterday, that tells the reader where to pause. Yesterday, they played a game. Let's go with 12. The truck grumbled how? Loudly. So, if I put loudly in the front of this, loudly, comma, the truck grumbled, period. So, that's consistent throughout. Adverbs go in different places in a sentence. They can. 13. We will go to the concert soon. When? Soon. Number 14. The boy waited patiently for the computer to load. How did he wait? Patiently. 15. Kayla finally arrived at the park. When did this happen? To what extent, maybe? Finally. Number 16, my mother nicely reminded me to do my homework. How did she do this? Nicely. Now, boys and girls, if a mom reminds her children nicely about their homework, she might say something such as, "Sweetheart, did you get your homework done?" Yeah, that's how most moms do that. But some moms might not say that so nicely. Some moms might do this harshly. For instance, if your mom comes up to you and says, "Did you get your homework done? Did you get your homework done?" Your mom's probably not saying it nicely.
You get your butt off that couch, and you get your booty to the kitchen table, and you get your homework done.
Yeah, that's what happens when some moms tell you harshly and not nicely. Just for the record. Number 17. The kitten walked there. The word there is an adverb, it sure is. But it doesn't end in ly, doesn't matter. It tells where about the action walked. Number 18. I usually lock the car door. How often do you do that? Or maybe to what extent? Usually. I always lock it. I sometimes lock it. We have lots of adverbs that are interchangeable there that really determine the degree of how often you do that. Number 19. My dog always barks. How often? To what extent does that dog bark? Always. Never stops. 24 hours a day. Keeps people up all the time. And number 20. Peter neatly wrote a shopping list. How did Peter do that? He did that neatly. So we add up the minus, all the minus ones that we have, and again subtract that from 30. Again, a perfect paper is plus 30 over 30.
Captain Cheesehead
and Mr. Southerton,
over
and
out.